So just a little overview of what Bharti Infratel does, because we are in the passive infrastructure side, so benefits for you guys also to know what we do. So we create these towers for the active side to actually maintain their operations. Now, to break it down further, what our business involves is actually taking a lot of civil, mechanical, electrical engineers. And as an organization, and laugh if you may, we have been extremely ambitious with our diversity targets. So, of course, I know of organizations where they identify roles like finance and HR where it's easy to find women folks, and we are talking about gender diversity first, then I'll get to the other sort of diversity. In Bharti Infratel, we've been extremely ambitious to say that we'll get women in the field, which means we will get women with a background of civil engineering, mechanical engineering, and electrical engineering to go and do a 24/7 job in the field, which means that if there is any problem in the tower anywhere in the country, and if that tower comes falls under their purview, they need to go fix it. Okay? So that means that I need to go back to my campuses and do a little math for you guys. 4,500 AICTE-approved colleges in India, 8.5 students who enroll in it annually. The men and the women number looks like this. 71% of men enroll and 29% of women enroll. So that's my beginning point of where I get women engineers in my field. Then I should come to the kind of changes that we've made within our organization. So if we're talking about having tie-ups with shops, having tie-ups with marketplaces where if they are on their PJP, they can visit the restrooms there, because we don't really have an office for these women to sit in. We have, because it's a 24/7 job, we have ensured that any call of duty that comes before 8 a.m. and after 8 p.m., they are specifically given a cab-driven or a driver-driven cab to support them to go anywhere. And of course, we've done a lot of branding exercises in colleges as well and on our website, which shows other women in the similar roles talking about the challenges that they face with the men folks and how fulfilled they feel. So all of these small and big initiatives, and of course, what Himanshu mentioned, may sound small, but it's worked wonders for us. We have moved to a double-digit figure in terms of diversity in our organization. We have literally taken a goal and given it functionally and geographically to each of our business leaders, saying that HR is not the only one who's going to bang their head against the wall just to ensure that there is gender diversity. It's all your priorities. And they literally have it in their goal sheet as a KRA. So that's one. In terms of other diversity, I think our locations, because we operate in mostly tier C and tier D cities, which is Chura Chandrapur in Northeast somewhere, I'm not too sure how many of you know about it. Jajpur in Orissa, again, not sure how many of you know about it, but similar cities. And some of them have geopolitical disturbances and issues. There we have looked at SSC profiles, so men who have a background in the army, they work really well. So that's one diversity figure we look at. Another diversity figure we look at, and this is more in our office locations, of people with disability. So these three components form our diversity. And of course, I'll let you know about all the practices that we do for our gender diversity. I hope that answers.